Okay, so after the OpenXR fun business, rendering triangles and all that again, I've gone back and reloaded the work I did for mesh loading and basic animation. And I've merged it into the new application. So like on the header side, you can see this is the old model temp stuff, the bring up and tear down the models, functions, and what is needed, staging buffer, the buffers, allocations, and vertex and fragment descriptors for both boned and unboned stuff and the armature and animation stuff. And I've got switches here basically for turning from boned to unboned. So right now it's false, so it'll run just the unboned version of the model, which is just a square. Yep. And then if I turn it to true, it'll come up as an animated rectangular. Is it a rectangular or cuboid? Something like that. Yeah, this animated long cuboid of weirdness. So, with all the basics of that back in place, and the code down here, actually, let me undo the temp so I can actually get the coloration. Yep. Yeah, so it's all this stuff. I need to kind of repackage this into a more proper form rather than just having it all lying about in the main in the main application. So, give me a second while I remember exactly. The mesh loading stuff is here, so it's not too bad. I've got both these two. Okay. So, one of the first things will be the very basic structure, which is going to be holding this stuff. So, model, I guess I'll just put it in here. So, I'll just say it's like faux graphics mesh, I guess. I'll do it like this. I'll turn it into a handle later, but right now I need like a structure for mesh, which is going to include. So I need two types. So first of all, vertex and index buffer. I'll do this. Do I need vertex data size? Not really, but I do need 32t num indices. Start at zero. Mesh bones. I don't really need it for the graphics side, but I do need this information for hooking into animation. So it won't be part of this. But it'll be closer to much like what is vertex data size? I think I just use that temporarily when in the uploading portion as well. Yeah. Yeah. So I don't even need this here. Rid of that. Right. Oh, wait, hold on. What's this up here? Offsets equals. Ooh, I do use it when I'm dealing with binding the vertex buffers. For whatever reason. Offset start at 0. Oh, okay, yeah. It's for if I'm binding vertex buffers for the bone data. Because the bone data is an offset in the same buffer. Okay, so I do need it here for the moment. But rather, it'll become like VK device size time, and it'll be what? Offset. It'll start off at 0, or. Yeah, it'll stop at 0. If it's 0, then the bone data offset is just nothing. It's just 0 as well. Okay, so we'll put this stuff in here instead to start off with when we're uploading. Let's see. You're getting all the data size. We allocate the buffers. They go into. Let's include this. Model temp. Basically, it's the same thing, but with a temp mesh in front of it. Do that. Index buffer, index allocation. I don't require staging stuff. So what we'll do is we'll just remove these temporarily. And then wherever they become an error here, I'll figure out where to put that. Vertex alloc, index alloc. Okay, that's part. I guess I don't really need this here either. I can just put it down here and call it good. Somewhere down here. Make sure that works. It will, of course, require something that goes along the lines of. But later again. Later. Actually, that's. Like, what exactly do I have? That's in VK. Because it is basically just the runtime in the pipeline pool, which already stores its local its data locally anyways. Okay. Just like thinking the long game here, the longer game here, how I would do something. The handling the destruction. I'll probably have some kind of tied in mechanism to make it easier. Because what I would probably have to do is I photographics in runtime. Was it runtime? No, session. Like that. And then how would I get the appropriate session and a whole bunch of other nonsense that goes along with that. Anyways, so we got that, we got staging allocation and stuff. Vertex data size. Which I. Where was it? Mesh loading, vertex data size. Oh, wait, I set it to 0. Yeah, don't want that. Not quite yet. So I use it up here for the offset. Bonus set to true, it runs. Why? I'll have to figure that out. Sometimes it's crashing on the VKQ submit, sometimes not. Okay, that's that. Set chain go to mesh bone data offset. We'll do that. Bone data offset. What the? Yeah, what the hell's going on, man? Okay. Oh, yeah. That, please. Okay, why is Q0? What's destination Q family? Okay. What the hell? Okay. This is actually very strange. Sometimes there's Q. Okay, this is actually a real problem, and we'll have to figure it out later. Right now, I just like it only runs half the time for whatever reason. Unless it's kind of switching between, because I got like two graphics cards in here, but no, it should only be choosing the first every time, unless whichever one is first is changing each time as well. Based on the initialization order. That could be it. But they're both the same card. They're both RX 580s. But doesn't make any sense. Whatever. Mesh stuff. Do I have full graphics mesh? Temp mesh. Okay. So Okay, let's work on whatever this will become. Destruction of this uses what? Oh no, it'd have to be like private up there. Okay. Not great. Not very easy to. Okay, fuck it. We'll put it up. So I can have access to what I require. So this is just. Put it up here for the moment. Mesh on CPP goes in here. Move it. Log mesh. Nope, wrong one. It's you. Got that. Okay, we're in here. We include. Session. Session to session from handle. Then I gotta go through if all the particular types. So if then I gotta delete it. Buffer allocator. Same for the vertex buffer. Okay. And then on the final type, I'd actually have to delete it as well. But not quite yet. Okay. Right, it's VK still. Okay. So I don't actually have validation stuff turned on right now. Right. do that right now. Is there an ability for me to turn off XR entirely from just initializing right now? Just to save a little bit of time on the application startup. Not yet. Okay, so I'll actually do that real quick first. Settings. XR, force XR. By default, enabling XR is true. Settings. Okay, hold on. VR equals enable XR. Okay, we'll figure that out. Of course, it implies VR. That goes without saying. So don't put that there. I don't really think it's something I want to save. Not really. Okay, so we'll, XR will become false. As I say, enable false. Okay, yeah, that actually makes a little bit more sense than what I was doing. Enable and force. Then we got to go back to the main application. We got to say if. If that, then the rest will not necessarily follow. And XR session. What is the header name? No, it is XR session. Yes, and this also needs to become that. Right. No, it's a struct. Oh God, it's still that. Is it? Come on. Where is it? There it is. Session. if we needed force XR and we didn't get it, then we leave. Right, XR session. There it is, it's empty, okay. So let's see if we get any of the XR stuff on this application run through. No, and it booted up much faster. That's fine. Settings, no modifications here, modification here. Stage that. Whoop. Stage that. Okay. And that's it for the XR stuff. Okay. Oh, come on. To speed up application initialization. Got that out of the way. Just a minor little thing. So what was the other thing I was doing? I had validation and stuff, right? That's part of my settings file. It seemed to... Oh, there's the validation stuff right there at the end. I just didn't see it up here. I should probably add that as well to the initialization creation stuff. Come on. Do I not even have the log here? I do not have the log here. Okay, we'll just kind of do that. And then we'll do a thing. Add those little things here. Just so that it's there in the part of the verbose logs. Yeah. What? Now we have this stuff again. Why did they even try? Why? Okay, whatever. At a moment, we'll say. It's like the settings aren't even being added or applied. Why? It's just not reading it. Sorry? Adding validation layers to the new VK instance, which takes a while. Then they have the debugging stuff, debug logging, and then we have the VK queue because it's a garbage value for whatever reason. We'll figure it out in a minute. Why are you doing this to me? Why now? Why now? Okay, I should really get to the bottom of this then. Okay, resource uploader. Let's have a look at the creation of this thing and see why it keeps doing this. Let's see. Take me. Resource uploader. So for one thing, we'll add this to runtime. Actually, can I do the same thing with XR at the same time? That would be great. You, right there. Pretty simple. Do the same thing kind of here. Compiles up great, that's great. So do that. We added it to both runtime sets. Okay, that's out the way. Now it's back to resource loader, uploader, I should say. Let us see. Since I only create the one. Okay, transfer queue. equals 1, graphics Q equals 7. What? I'm sorry, hold on. How many frickin' Q families are there? Oh, I never blank them out before I start, before I create session. Whoops! I see now. Sometimes the garbage data made it look like the best queue was actually this other thing. So first of all, what can I do? P standard. Can I just standard fill? Times 8. Yeah, it's just this. What's the number? XQs per family. Pointers don't work as a reference to const of arbitrary type. Okay. How's about we do EKQ. Q family is this. It's got a standard mutex. So I actually have to like clear it. Fine. Why don't we just do this, eh? So we can just use the. We can just do go for auto. Actually, you know, what am I doing? I could just do this. doesn't matter. We do this, and then on the detection of the best cue, we make sure if p session nope. Oh yeah, yeah. If P session numqs equals 0, and just continue. You don't want to count empty queues. Your queue families that don't have anything. We still got a bit of a problem with what exactly. It's null by default anyways. Two queues. That makes a bit more sense. It's Radeon, so there's a dedicated transfer queue. That's great. That works. Okay, so that should solve that problem. Move the resource loader up a bit. Type defs. Resolved. Okay, queue nonsense dealt with. Good, 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 good. Okay, back to runtime. What was I? I was back going back to mesh now, which is where we started. We have this stuff we were dealing with, the deletion of stuff from meshes. Okay. Teardown of, yes, I do have a teardown function down here, right? Well, right now it's just that, so And it should be a pointer type, right? For the moment. So now at the end, after validation and stuff, I should have no more issues with those. Oh, come on! It's going for the XR stuff again. Why? Did I like delete stuff in here again in this? Yeah. Oh, I know what's going on. It's saving the data to the same settings file. Aren't ya? And because those are the settings that I don't say resave afterwards. Please do that. Validation layers. That's why it would only like run once with the stuff. Okay, there's still some. Was it VK fences, a semaphore, and a buffer? Not sure which buffer. Is do I not destroy? I submit the stuff. I probably don't destroy the. Graphics items. Okay, and that just leaves the semaphore and the fences, which I'll bet is the upload data here. Now, is, do I have an upload data like destruction type? I must have. I must have used it on the image stuff somewhere. Oh, it's a oh, it's just plain old like destroy. Does that fully clean me up again? I'm back at the baseline level of having a clean implementation. Yes. So that's progress again. Okay, let's split it up a bit more. So we have a mesh type. Or do I really? No, not yet. Don't do the handle quite yet. I don't need the handle. Because I'm still got everything at such a high level right now. Okay. So what I can do is like photographics mesh, create mesh. I can give it like the vertex, the size of the vertex and the index buffers I require. Number of indices and the bone data offset if I want, if I have it. I just basically, yeah, I create one, two, three, four variables. I return it. It also happens the have these things. Okay. And then I have the four items, which is what? You went 32. Like, is it a. Okay. Right now it's the size, so. Okay, device size, bone data offset, and bone data offset. And that's it. That doesn't even require me to have anything, any Vulkan specific stuff actually. Other than these. Which I can just change up to that and convert down if necessary. Although I would doubt that would be required. Return, Okay, so allocate model buffers is currently a lot of. Come on, take me there. This stuff, yeah. Vertex index buffer, which is this stuff. With that, I did. I determine if I want to have a staging buffer and allocation. Okay, what if what about a bool? Most visible, something like that. If one or both are host visible. And I'll only return true if they are both host visible. Like that, yeah. So I'll do something similar to this. Vertex index, that's great. Session from handle session. Okay. What the? That. Also need to include that. Most visible, well, only for the moment. We can do finer grain control later sometime. Otherwise, right now, I only want to deal with putting stuff into GPU memory as well. So if it gets any deeper than this, I'll probably have to start do like a create in mesh create info type struct and pass that in instead of just these. Okay. Let's try that, shall we? For this size, index data size. Okay. Really? I did add mesh here, yeah. So what's going on? Yes, the Boolean. Okay, so that's that stuff. Now, unfortunately, I do have a bit of a problem with this stuff at the moment. Where it'd be like if, because this the staging buffer and staging allocation would be attached to the upload data, wouldn't it? And they are on an individual basis at the moment as well. Okay. Do this quickly here. Get rid of that. So we map model buffers. Okay. What's going on in here? Allocate the buffers, but we already. So what's going on in here? What exactly was going on in here? Map memory. Oh yeah, if we have a staging allocation, yeah, that makes sense. So what we probably want to do instead is this. We have an index buffer and, or rather, sorry, staging and allocation buffer. That's it. If the original buffers are host visible, then there's no need for staging. That is what I want to do. So allocate this in Where do I have this hiding? It's gonna be allocator. We have the staging stuff. That's it. Oh no, I'd also need a uint. That. I'd also need the data size. With the new buffers, that's that. CPU only, that's the type we want. Staging allocation, that's great. VK res, and we want it to be that size. That plus this. That's running. That is, oh, there, yes it is. Okay, it's back to this point again. Create the mesh has this stuff. Mapping the model buffer data, copying the data in. Right now, uploading is still on an atomic basis, so I can work with that, yeah, for the moment. Submission, destruction. Okay, let's see if we can. Okay, what about on the rendering side? Let's work through some of the rendering stuff then. Index and that buffer. These things are void, right? Yeah. this is like Vulkan specific stuff as well. See if we can do it here for the moment. Just about in here. So the mesh we're operating with. Maybe something like this. So it'll be an end, yeah. Okay, we do that. Data two, otherwise it's one. Mesh on index data. Temp mesh. And whether it's boned or not. Sorry, it's the other way around. I need this as well for the mesh data as well. Do-do-do-do. Was it VK index type? So almost. I still need to pass in the index type, which is unfortunate. So I almost got away without it, but I do need it. Okay, looks like MD's starting to die. Save all. Really? That's interesting type, but okay, I'll work with it. So back up here, we got that. We for binding. Let's see how that works. Not quite. Oh, yes, here, data size. Where is it? There it is. Okay, and if we were to change it to false, so it's no longer bound. It's just that. Okay. So what I'll take is I'll take this stuff. Come on. Where is it? Oh, it's just behind. That's binding of the mesh. Which I'll probably want to move to a like swap this around to have it more based on the command buffer than the mesh. Much like how they have VK command and stuff. System data, it's a count of 2, starting from offset 1. So set this back to true. And still, Okay, what's it? An hour and a half. Okay, so I think I'll kind of leave this part here. Well, actually, not quite, because what I want to, I'm going to actually properly. What are you doing? Yes. Mesh. I'll probably make a handles for him. Graphics. Mesh, we have this type. It's a session type. Then down here, for this side, VK mesh, we'll change this around. So this goes down to the source side. Runtime, and that will have these types. Why can you not do it? Whoops, why can you not do it? Reinterpret cast from that is not allowed. Why? Oh, because it's still defined here? I need to actually save this. So we need a namespace for the proper one of this. Okay. Scrap that. We need to include. We don't. Yes, we do need this. Nope, not quite. Why? Faux graphics export. That should be brought in by this, right? You bring this in. Why? Top level, yeah. Do I actually have to, like, oh, that's why the names, the if defs macros were the exact same. Okay, let's see what else we got. We got unknown type name, VMA allocation. That's fine. Do that. That's good. Next issue. interpret. So it's basically free. Still some things around that are not exactly happy about the whole deal, such as draw indexed. Get them indices. Which would be from the lower one, not the VK one. Nope. You. Okay, application. We also need to change temp mesh is still actually that. It's a handle type now. Which means we got that. We got a number of other issues, such as we don't have this stuff anymore. Oh, yeah, okay, I see what's going on. We did that, so replace that one, and that one, and that one. Okay. What else we got? We got problems with the... Yes, the vertex. No, not you. Num indices. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. And then that just leaves the buffers and the allocations. Or not even the buffers, just... No, we need the buffers too. Okay, for the moment. Yep, more temporary nonsense. One of these days. Or at least while the rest of the implementation slowly matures around it. That's what I'll say to myself. Figure out like the rest of the process for uploading stuff or abstracting the uploading of data will become what we got here. Again, these are just okay, let's get this stuff in at least. So we got this for graphics mesh. Okay, I got the mesh. We've got this stuff in. And this stuff is isolated by itself. Anything egregiously wrong? Actually, just to be sure, I do not have address. Quickly rebuild everything with that and make a quick run with the address allocator or address sanitizer. Make sure I'm not accidentally losing memory based on this stuff anyways. Doesn't work under that stuff. Okay, that's great. Whatever. Not great. Let's see what we've got. We do have some stuff we're losing. Such as, in here, the fragment descriptor pool. When we create a new fragment descriptor, I'm not deleting them properly. Okay. I guess it makes sense. Okay, is there anything from the mesh stuff that I'm doing? Then I can come back to the shader pools stuff. Shader pool. Okay, I gotta do a quick pass of the shader pool and this other stuff to whack down all of these fragment descriptor, shader pool. Okay, so it doesn't look like from my new stuff. It's from my older stuff when I was less smart about my memory management. Okay. Call it there on this one. With graphics mesh portion mostly taken care of right now, I need a class that sits above that deals with loading and unloading the mesh data basically, as well as the bone data. And I need also like to do something about the armature and animations. So to start, it's gonna have to be. Let's get something up going on in here. Mesh. HPV, whatever. Let's get a. Oh, don't even have one there. Oh, do we have a faux mesh? A faux graphics mesh. We have the bone data, which is this. This will be what the name. I guess I'll just leave it as a name. It'll be like the file name. Mesh name, since that'll always fit under the scene node. Then I'll have to do have a look at that afterwards as well. Okay, mesh data. like this. That's what I need. I need Is there anything else I really need at this point? Finder, okay. I think I'm going to have to like do some kind of split between what foe and like a lower level kind of type as well, because it's got, the namespace is going to be get a bit busy, or I could actually use C++ namespaces as well. Well, in any case. Actually, you know what? Do it like that for now. Keep it a bit simpler, more straightforward. And then we'd have something for like unloading it as well. Or do I want to just do like an int into the array for the moment rather than a direct pointer? Well, no, for the moment, just to keep things simpler, I'll just do that. Just direct pointers to this stuff, and then I'll abstract it a bit more later. away. Anytime we're doing anything, we want to lock that up. Do we? For the moment, anyways. Lock it up, then we go through. This is likely, yo. And we'll kind of put it in brackets to make it a bit simpler. Unknown. This could be reference likely. Attribute likely, unlikely, since like 20, right? Let me just know. You know what? I'm not even going to bother there then. Continue. Otherwise, we found it, we return. We can determine if it's loaded or not based on if this is null or not. Which actually, hold on. That'll be empty. These will be empty. Not found, create it. Or still locked in. Oh, I need to do, whoops. It doesn't matter for this guy, actually, but it does matter for this guy. Create a little constructor on this one then, actually. All right, we can get down to the loading. Actually, do this real fast because this is even faster. Oh, yeah, because of this data, I also need like an initialize. Okay, so I need to go through 4. Now we go for the other one. And then at this point, what we're going to do is basically what's in here. So you need to get up to this point. You only want to do this if there's actually stuff. obvious. Now we have to find the particular okay, do I even have the ability to enumerate through these things? No, I do not. All right. So, what exactly, mesh? Okay, that'll work. I need the number of meshes. right, yes. Okay, now we got that. Do that. Whatever. Can I do standard string or string view actually? Nope, not quite. Oh, crap, actually, that's because I don't even return that. I just return a boolean for now. Okay. Do we get all this stuff? Vertices, by the way. What is this? Do I not even check if I have this? No, I do not. Okay, we got this stuff, then we move on to pretty much just this stuff. Oh boy, there's a bunch of this stuff. Okay. Okay, now I need these. The graphics stuff done. To create one of these, which I believe is just like this. I need to go through four. Did I not actually have this already? I don't. I thought I did. got all that stuff. Did we actually put it in place? Yeah, we did, because we put it straight in. Didn't we? Yes, we did. Okay, let's just see if it works, then we'll kind of put some more error prevention into it. So what would it be? It'd be this application here. This is tall animated cuboid, and then it's cube. Okay. I got this a little bit backwards, but okay. See how this goes. Something bad is about to happen. I am sure of it. I think this is a bunch of garbage data. That's great. We have something, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Illegal instruction. Oh, I didn't return anything. So I want to make sure that. Okay, first of all, we have that. Then we're going to have animation pool, destroy mesh. For the moment, we'll have both of them actually. Like that. I loaded it up, and then what I'm going to do is. Okay, we're not on bones, so let's try without bones and see what we get. Looking all right. Let's do true, and then we'll remove the items from the application. Oh, yeah. Do I have like the. I don't have validation and stuff being pulled in. I don't know why it's taking so long. Maybe it's the sanitizer. But it looks good. Regardless. So. Get rid of those. Get rid of mesh bones and temp mesh. This also means we remove a lot of this stuff. A lot of it, but not quite all of it. So what's this? It's looking good. Looking very nice. So I don't really need this here anymore. I do need it on the C++, the source side. Meshes, animation, these both still required. Okay. It's getting a little better. Now for the next. Portion, which is probably going to be, I'm not sure if I want to do the descriptors yet, or I want to kind of work on the armature animation stuff. Okay, so with the mesh kind of graphics stuff being loaded that way, now I have to kind of do the same thing with armatures and animations. Now I've created a new file, anim cube, animated cube, and added, I think I got two animations on this thing. Two animations. So I need a system for packaging armatures and animations that sits next to the models, the meshes, because multiple meshes could reuse the same armature and animations. Think of like human people, right? Everyone, well, most people have a similar bone layout and structure. We can reuse the same skeleton and animations across a wide variety of meshes and models and what have you, or bits and pieces of humans, people. So having armatures and animations be separated from the meshes is kind of a requirement here. Of course, there are some that will be one-to-one. Like there are some animations that only go for certain types of models and what have you, or meshes. But that's also basically handled by the same, if they're separated or together as well. So let's see if we can get this armature. Let's get this kind of a system together here, and then we'll move on. For now, I need a file name where I'm loading it from. Just the name of the armature. Going back to application. What do we have? We have two things. Well, yeah, we will have two things. We'll have a vector of armature nodes. And the list of animations. We'll pull them all in. Let's see what we've got. Do I require? No, I do not require anything for. I don't need any external stuff to initialize or deinitialize. Do I? No, I really don't think I do. I mean, okay, I won't even bother with removal of stuff yet. That is. Okay, later, 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 later. Go through with deleting them all. That's great and all. Mean, technically, I could do a memory like a smart pointer. I really could. I'm not gonna. This basically be the same as this, wouldn't go through them all. Continue. You found it. Turn it. We need a constructor. Then we need the load function. Which will be somewhat similar to start with. So, what do we need? We need this. We're going to load this stuff. This will equal model loader armature. What is in an animation type? Exactly. Things I can just move in, no problem. Okay. I can work with that. I think. Okay. So in the application, when we pull in animation, it's just like, it's just that. Okay, what is that? It's just flow animation. Okay. Armatures, we pull in. Import that one. Or rather, if I just do that, I can just do that for now. Place back that for all the animations. Seems like there's not actually all that much going on here. Would have expected a bit more. Okay, well, application, what we got? Okay, we'll basically do this. So got these. Load that, that'll import that stuff. We got similar down here. Put these values. I'll pull in these guys. Okay. That means, though, I need to up here grab this. For the moment, keep the data here. And then I need to pass these guys in to the animation. This. So we p-armature data dot animations zero. The first animation for that. Let's see how that goes. So the first one is just rotating cube of some sort, and I'm not even.
Okay, not great. Why did it not load? What's atom cube? Okay. Great. We do have a new armature. It's this one. We're going in. Bringing the armature, which is six, I guess. Bone that. Whatever. We have two animations. That's good. With these guys going on. Okay. All right. Where did we die? We died here. Why? Time is P animation. Why am I not? Main loop. I'm here. Armature data is real. Animations is real. Did I not load it? Am I create? Am I. What? He's got real stuff. He does not. Color me super confused. What's in armatures? We have. Why do we have three? This is very strange. Let me guess, I screwed this. Yes. Back to meshes. We'll do the same thing here. I think. No. Yes. Okay. There we go. Sorry, what am I looking at? This is something massive. And it's not moving either. What? Okay, let's change back to the tall cuboid. Maybe it's something to deal with scaling. Maybe FBX exports from Blender has a completely different scaling factor that I'm not aware of. Because this looks right. All right. I only have so. Come on, let me in. Thank you. We go, we have, okay, what's the vertex size? Damn it. One, one, negative one. Okay, so this is a regular size. It's 1.0. That's great. No fancy business. Same thing again, right? Times transform. One, negative one, one. Yeah, no freaking problem there. But it looks mass. Okay, let's turn animation off. Or bones off. Okay, so turning that off reveals a regular sized everything. And if I was to go for the collider version of this, this may just be a FBX only thing. Right, yeah, I should probably load that version as well. Oh, yeah, we don't need this anymore either. Nor will we require it here, right? We don't need it. Yes, goodbye. Don't need to know this stuff. That was temporary. No. Okay, animated cube de collada version. So without the stuff, that's great. And we turn the bones and animation back on. We get this, but it's moving as well. So it looks all right. I mean, it animates, but it's not massive. So, I guess I can go into okay, that's actually a weird thing. Let's try that. What if we have just the FBX mesh data? I mean, same thing. It looks weird, but, you know, it's okay. It's, whoops. It's specifically the FBX animation data. So, yeah, like, what is this? So big, I don't even... Let's see if there's like some really weird scaling keys or something going on. Animations, first one, node channels. Yeah, there's only a few things. So is there any scaling keys? Yes, there's a lot of scaling keys. Wait, what am I reading? Time two? Is it like one per tick? Are you kidding me? That's terrible.
But scaling isn't that crazy either, so. Oh, there we go. It's freaking like times 100. Why? You guys crazy? Doesn't look like it. You? All right. Right then. What do I do? Can I knock off the armature nodes? No, like. Okay, what do we do about animation, right? So the time is what? 2.63. That's great. So we'll go through. Continue. Oh no, I can't. I need to have the bone in there. Right. Because I'm going to imagine. Wait, hold on. Are my bones expecting them to be the same as in the same layout as the armature? That's probably a mistake. Like a pretty big frickin' mistake. Bone size. There's two bones. There's bone and bone one. And I'm going to bet right now the first channel is going to be like the armature channel. And that's where it's getting its garbage data from. Oh, okay. Right. Okay, I need to draw up some kind of armature to bone translation layer. I need to match bones with armature nodes rather than whatever the hell this was. Expect it, just hoping that they matched all the time. Okay. Since what we care about are the bones, what we're going to have to do is go back to that instead, won't we? So transform times bones offset matrix. So, need to go back to the channel. For each bone, we need to try to find the animation channel that corresponds to it. So, for to do it inline for the moment. I hate it, but what am I going to do? You can come on, just I want this is all I want. That great. Go through all the animation channels. If channel dot what do I use bones here for? Just that. Okay, there we go. And then we have P channel, right? That. Okay. P channel has bone for bone. Bone 01 for bone 01. Okay. What's that look like? Extremely slow. Why? What's P animation? Duration 99 ticks per second, 24. Okay. Okay, what did this look like with DAE1? Well, let's just frickin' load both of them for the moment. Just make it easier for me up here. It's something I can do, and I will do it! It's broken. All right. Armature bone 001. Okay, the types are incompatible with each other. They have different names depending on the file format. Thanks, Blender export people. Okay. I shall acquiesce to your nonsense. Armature bone, there's two bones, it's just these two, and then in this case there's only two channels as well. And in this case it was what? It was duration of 4 point something with like one tick per second or so. So it basically followed, right? Yeah. So then it followed basically like that, no problem. And the other one was what? 99 divided by 24, right? Let me just write that down. 4 point, what was it? 4 point something? Do. Something, whatever. Pause here, please. And this is 99 out of 24. Bring up your old calculator. 4.12. Okay, basically close to the same. Not quite, though. Duration divided by ticks. And like, how's this work? Time 99. I see. So I need to do two things. First of all, this is times P animation. Okay. Second, whoops. Is it like a W, right? Divided by that, yes. 4 point divided by one is 4 point whatever still. So this will be about the same. And then what I want this for the time. T-
times p animation ticks per second. I'll need to times it by 24 to get the correct animation cycle. Give that a roll. First of all, I want to make sure total duration is what I think it is. 4 point whatever, yeah. And we've got time, times, yeah, whatever. Let's have a look at the animation. Nope, still extremely slow. Oh, because I'm not even, yeah. Animation time, animation time, animation time. Go, 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 go. And it's probably scaling to that. Doesn't seem to quite match what I had for DAE for animation. It's supposed to be the same animation. No, it actually looks... it's the first animation for both. What's the name of the animation? There's two animations, of course. Maybe I've accidentally got the second one loaded into the DAE. There's no name given with the animation for DAE. Okay, let's open the file. Do, 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 do. Anim cube DAE. What's the name of the animation? Pose me. Oh my god, what is all this? What? What is this? Where is it? I don't understand. Okay, let's open up the... what we got? We got two animations. Let's make sure we're exporting the first one to Collada. Which I did today. Do that. It's called first animation. Okay, it's first animation. It's really. It just modifies. Okay, if there is not a channel. Otherwise it goes to a identity matrix, which I guess makes sense. Or not, sure, we'll do that too. Okay. Now it's going. What the hell? Okay, whatever. I must have exported it with some weird. Orientation. Forward axis is Y. What?
the animation, which only excludes exports one for whatever reason. Let's give that a go again. That's spooky. It's got some kind of terrible thing going on. Okay. I need to go to the home. Let's get the raw file again, because I must have mucked these up enough. Unfortunately, the original only has data, one animation, models, tall animated cuboid. Okay, where on earth did I put that then? It must be in here somewhere. No, back up, model. Test data, there we go, these guys. Copy them in here. Right, overwrite, overwrite. Okay. So this is what I have. Let's open it up in Blender real quick. See what we got. We have just one random something or other. And it does this, then resets back. Don't save it. Got that. Okay, wonderful. And then we try the same thing on FBX. Looks about the same now. Okay. All right. Well, at least I fixed up some animation stuff as well. It's probably, I gotta do like a cache between bones and armature nodes now. Or animation nodes. Or, what's probably going to happen is I'll apply animation. I'll have each, okay, what is this? Each entity has armatures, I have animations, I apply those animations to those armatures, and then using those armatures, I do the bone animation off of, rather than using the animation directly for bones. But that's down the line. That's down the line. Okay. But I got the armature stuff in. I've cleaned out application just a little bit. Okay, animation pool. Probably want to split meshes up between graphics meshes and other types of meshes, such as physics meshes and what have you. Or would it be physics? Physics models? Or something like that. Yeah. Armatures. Application. Stuff a little cleaned up. I mean, it's easier to use now, at least. All right, I guess I need to roll back to this to these descriptor vertex and fragment descriptors now. Figure out a way to kind of systemize them a little bit more. All right, cheers.